Welcome to another interesting edition, another episode of Living Your Dreams television broadcast. Living Your Dreams television broadcast is a product of Living Your Dreams initiative, a signature ministry of Femme Foundation International, a life development assembly that concentrates on making men know the person and the power of the Holy Spirit, raise, build healthy relationships, and raise leaders, godly raise leaders for global transformation. Like we always say, as part of our mission to build healthy relationship, this television broadcast is fulfilling that mission. And we are looking at challenges that people find within the confines of marriage. We have looked at assignment, we looked at identity. Today, we'll be looking at finance as one of the major issues that cause problems in marriage. Finance causes two kinds of problems. Some people have too much of it that there's no more time for family. Like one of my daughter and friends will say, family time. Some people have so less of it that it is bringing a strain in their marriage relationship. And people do not know what to do with the account. Should they be joint account? Should we have separate accounts? So let's look at finance. What is the purpose of finance? Money is a very, very good messenger, but a very bad leader. Money does not lead well, but if you send money on an errand, he will go. Money in the hands of someone who understands his assignment, who understands his identity, who understands his identity, will better the society, will bring about goods and services that would save the marriage, stop bad marriages from happening, and strengthen every part of our national life. Money in the hands of someone who does not understand his assignment, who does not understand his identity, will be for show, will be for mammon reasons. To build an empire, to show off that this is me, I have money. And no, but if you talk, I will silence you with a phone call. That's not the job of money. Money does not have a character, but money takes the character of the owner. So if the owner is arrogant and does not care about society and cares only about himself, me, myself, and I, money in his hands will do this. If the owner, in the other hand, is the opposite. So if you bring all this within the context of marriage, we understand that money is supposed to be used to render service. So it means that I shouldn't allow money send me on an errand. I should be the one sending money on an errand. Positive errand. So, how does this bring challenge in marriage? Some people have made so much money, they have lost their children. Their children are alive, but they are lost. They have lost their wives, they have lost their families because of money. Because I need to get more and get more and get more. So we don't understand for a child, love is spelled at time, as time. Please, you need to organize yourself in such a way that your children will not live life. And when you have to start introducing them to their father. I had a story of a man who comes home when the children have gone to bed and then leave the house before the children who wake up. One day, this man came home earlier than scheduled, and the children were in the sitting room watching television, and the children ran to the sitting room. Mommy, mommy, that man, that uncle that always comes when we go to bed and when we are sleeping and before we wake up has come back. And that taught him a lesson. A very wealthy man in the U.S. was arrested and put in jail. And when they interviewed his son, the son said, I wish that we can reverse the hand of the clock, that I will have time to spend with my daddy. So my daddy gave me the best of the toys. When we grew up, my daddy provided everything money can buy. But there is something my dad did not provide. My daddy never provided himself. Let me ask you a question. If you put money in a room and the house is filled with money and you need comfort, would that money be able to put hands around you and comfort you? I've told people that the greatest source of wealth is human beings. If you need to be nursed, will that money nurse you? If you need to be If you need to render any service that has to do with what human beings can do, money cannot do so. If you have that at the back of your mind, it simply means that you also understand that some of the things we use money to do for our children, that money cannot do it. Never get to a point where you are too busy that you will not be able to do school runs. Because during school runs, children talk when going to school and they talk while coming back. That's when you have time to bond. So please create time for that. Wow. Some people have so much money that this money has bought girlfriends that is causing a strain in their relationship with their wives. Some people say it doesn't matter as far as money can do it. You don't want to live life, and when you are old, you regret some steps you took. And let's talk about where money is not enough. This is a major stress in marriage, because your family is asking for some things. You cannot provide them. You feel less than a man that you cannot provide them. However, the Bible said that whosoever cannot provide for the family. So at that particular point in time, we must get to a place where we understand that provision has to be complementary as well. Sometimes in the modern world, they say that more women are receiving more than their husband. If you find yourself to such a point, don't ever let it get to your head where you don't remember that the role you are given to play in your husband's life is not the role of headship. I didn't say leadership, I said headship. Your husband was given the role of headship. So the money in your hands should serve the purpose that his headship position is not destroyed because of this. And there has to be understanding where you know that this person I'm stressing and I'm dragging that you must bring money, he doesn't have it. And if he doesn't have it, how do we create balances and understanding to say at this particular point in time, this is where we are. This has to do with understanding and patience. And many of us in Nigeria, patience is not one of the things we have. Many of us are in a hurry. So we need to also advise where money is not enough. It means there has to be understanding. And in addition to understanding, we, those of us who are involved, need to look within and ask for creative ideas from God our Father on ways that we can bring in goods and services that will be able to solve problems. But within those times where money is not enough, we're asking for understanding. We're asking for patience so that we don't degenerate where we begin to fight and our children will begin to watch us. All right? I know that in our country now, people are going through trying times. People are going through difficult times. This is the time where all of us need to go on our knees and begin to pray to the Father. I can give you three methods, because 90% of the problems we have in marriage is caused by finance. Three methods. A joint account, where all of us dispense from that account. However, these things cause problems, because the woman, the man usually is a treasurer, so he will make the decision. Sometimes you find out that before you even know what is happening, this man, the money has been dispensed in a way you don't understand. So he will convince you, I have to buy this shoe or this shirt because we need it for this interview. You know, it's for PR. And then maybe the woman now comes and says, please, I need to buy this dress. The woman says, dress? Inside this one, when we did so, then you won't buy this.